Hello, Galaxy! I'm Chris Pirillo, and you're watching the Locker Gnome Daily Report, or TLDR for short. I'm actually doing this recording live on Twitch. I'm streaming live on Twitch, as I am every night at 6 p.m. You can join me and the rest of the community over there every night if you'd like to geek out. And tonight, I'm geeking out about this! An Intel NUC, or I call it a NUC. NUC, Next Unit of Computing. This is a very small and powerful PC. And I don't hear a lot of people talking about this, or as many people as I'd like to see talking about it, because this has been easily the best form factor for a PC, a non-portable PC, really, as in not a laptop PC, for me. And I didn't know about it until recently, in recent years, I should say. This was my first NUC. I'm actually on my second NUC, the one that I'm using to record this video and stream live video at the same time. Very, very nice. I'm glad that I work at Intel. In fact, when I told the NUC team, or the NUC team, that I was planning on doing this video, they got excited. And then I got excited, because it's really exciting when you find something that works very, very, very well. And I wanted to run through like 10 reasons why the NUC is the perfect PC for me. And again, non-portable, non-laptop PC. That was my primary use case, because I needed something as a creator, streamer, I needed something that just worked. And I have certain parameters in which I operate, certain needs that the NUC, you know, in just using this particular NUC, this one here, the one obviously that I'm not actively using in the recording of this video, you know, it showed me that it was possible to have a powerful PC without having that PC dominate the desk. And that's, I'm a huge, huge fan of that. So here, I'm just going to rattle off 10 reasons and then, of course, go back and dive a little deeper. These are the reasons I love my NUC. It's the best PC for me. It's small. It has everything I need. I'm not a modder. I keep it completely out of the way, and it can be. I use it for live streams, so it's powerful, very powerful. I could probably throw even more at it, and it would still handle things without a hiccup. I don't need to go mobile with it. I can still push 120 FPS across two monitors with this thing, if not more. I hadn't tried more than just two. For upgrades, I'm not someone who would necessarily swap out components. I would look to do like platform upgrades, as in I'm waiting for the next NUC to come along. The Alder Lake NUC is right around the corner, at least at the time of this recording. And I'm just saying, I'm available, because I got a Tiger Lake, which is very, very, very powerful. But, you know, there's a new, more powerful computer that's coming down the pike, and I want it. I don't even know what it is yet, and I can tell you, I want it. So that would be my type of upgrade. I would upgrade the entire NUC rather than just upgrading components in it. And that's usually the type of upgrader I am anyway. It's quiet. It doesn't produce much heat. It's got configurable performance parameters in software. And then the last reason, because these are my list of 10 and I'm going to go back. It's largely provided an uncluttered software experience, which for me, when it comes to Windows, is important, because I'm a software enthusiast. I like running lean, mean, and clean. I don't need too much software getting in the way and possibly causing problems, but I haven't had any issues with plugging in external devices and driver support. Of course, it's Windows. And I also have not had any issues running into any kind of third-party software from an OEM that doesn't really exist with this particular NUC. So it has everything I need. It ticks all the boxes and doesn't tick me off. That's probably the most important factor for me when it comes to picking up a computer, that I'm not dissatisfied with it. It does its job, and I feel like maybe it's not necessarily future-proof, that's the wrong word, but that I could use it for years to come without necessarily having to upgrade to the latest and greatest. In fact, I could probably still be using this particular NUC it's a few years old now, to power the stream and be just fine. It's just that, you know, the newer generations would, you know, make it a little more smooth, right? Less CPU time, less GPU time, which of course frees up resources to do a great many things. So going back through this list, it is small. Like I cannot, you know, overstate this enough. Tiny. Like I'm holding it in my hands. But again, one of those reasons I got it is not just because of the size, but because it's powerful. You got all these ports. Thunderbolt, USB, Ethernet. This particular one had a couple of jacks, but I only used one. HDMI, DisplayPort. There's ports on the front. including headphone jack, SD card slot. There's a Kensington lock slot, I think, on the side. So it's small, powerful. I shouldn't smack the PC. Sorry that I didn't want to draw anything loose. I don't think I did. Everything is pretty much solid state. That's how I also prefer my PCs. No moving parts, except for the fans, which you never really hear. I mean, they may be happening right now. The fans may be going. You can actually configure the fan performance and software on the NUC, which is nice. But I have it set for max performance, but balanced with the fans. So inevitably, I don't have fan noise. The only fan that you might hear in this video is the fan that is on the 3D printer, me 3D printing little Pac-Man ghosts for Halloween. Ah, it's kind of fun, little cute thing. I have space on my desk for a 3D printer, but in terms of a PC, not right now. Maybe at some point in the future, like a Star Wars themed custom PC. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool. But again, then I have to worry about size, and then I have to worry about power, and then I have to worry about fans and heat. And I don't have to worry about that with the NUC. And this is to me, the most critical part of this, the prospect. Like, it's out of the way. It's tucked away behind the desk. I got cables coming out, connected to everything that they need to be connected to. But I just don't need to see the PC. I don't want to see the PC. Like, I use laptops because the keyboard's attached and you got the screen. It's like an all-in-one device. But I needed something for a scenario where it was just set it and forget it. Don't even worry about it. You've got it connected. You can interact with it, but you don't need to see the actual hardware. And that's, you know, been the way that I've had my PC for a while. It's always been tucked behind the desk, but inevitably I'd always have to go behind it, do things with it, you know, mess with things. I don't have to do that with a NUC. Like, rarely, if ever. Sometimes, usually when there's like a power outage, I might have to go behind the desk, but I don't have to do it all that often. So it is capable of handling everything I throw at it. It takes up no space at all, is expandable to the point where I believe I may still have a few ports that are open, but most of them are set. Most of them are good. I have everything that I need, you know, going in and coming out of the PC. And, you know, that's something that, you know, in terms of my use case, I thought was very important. I cannot believe that more people are not talking about NUC. I know Curly did. Now that was NUC. NUC, NUC, NUC. But this is no joke. Like, this is seriously a powerful PC that so many people don't know exists. So I thought, all right, I'm doing this on my own volition. Yes, I work for Intel, but I'm doing this because I'm using it. I'm doing it, yes, because they sent it to me specifically to use, but not necessarily to ask me to do this. I'm doing this because it's one of those things that when you realize this type of PC exists, suddenly you get a different idea of what a PC could be. Something very powerful, something very small, something that could run very silent, very cool, but still be powerful enough to do the things that you need to do. And then the software experience, to me, that's like the cherry on top, is the fact that there aren't a lot of cherries on top. Like, it's something where you could configure a NUC and basically get a NUC system that has exactly what you need without too much, and pay an amount that is perfect for your budget. But to me, it's less about budget and more about what's the PC that I need. What's the PC that I'm looking for? And I'm telling you, every one of these checkboxes that I had, like, mentally, I didn't even realize that were already checked off by the NUC. So if you're not aware of it, at least you are now. I can't promise that I know everything about the NUC. I don't know everything about PCs, but I just know what I like, and I know what I appreciate, and I've appreciated the ability to use a system like this. Instead of just talking about it, I like using something, because those, to me, those types of experiences speak volumes. No one's ever complained about the performance of my live stream. There's a reason for that. I'm using an Intel NUC.